किस तरह से किया, क्योंकि वो जल्दी हाँ कहते नहीं है किसी विषय के लिए।
ये सवाल शायद, सवाल का जवाब शायद वो ही बेहतर दे पाएंगे।
लेकिन कितना टाइम लगा कन्विंस करने में वो तो बोल दो।
2.5 मिनट।
एक्चुअली व्हेन स्वाति टोल्ड मी अबाउट द कॉन्सेप्ट, शी सेड कि आई वांट टू मेक अ फिल्म ऑन फॉरगिवनेस, एंड शी टोल्ड मी द 2 or 3 स्टोरीज व्हिच यू ऑल आर सीइंग इन वेरी शॉर्ट, कि शेर के ऐसा, वंता के साथ हुआ था ऐसा, समुंदर के साथ ऐसा हुआ था। तो द मोमेंट शी टोल्ड मी दैट द कॉन्सेप्ट इज फॉरगिवनेस, आई सेड आई एम ऑन, वी आर प्रोड्यूसिंग इट, यू मेक इट।
आमिर सर,
एंड एट दैट टाइम आई जस्ट फुल्ली आंसर दिस, एट दैट टाइम आई डिडंट नो कि इसको हम कहाँ, दर्शकों को हम किस तरह दिखाएंगे। मेरे मन में कुछ नहीं था, थिएट्रिकल रिलीज होगी, डिजिटल प्लेटफॉर्म पे जाएंगे, आई हैड नो आइडिया। आई जस्ट सेड स्वाति व्हाट यू हैव इन माइंड इज सो इम्पॉर्टेंट, वी मस्ट मेक इट, सो AKP इज गोइंग टू प्रोड्यूस इट। जब बन जाएगी तब हम सोचेंगे कैसे दिखाना है। और जब फिल्म मैंने देखी फर्स्ट कट, तो इतना गहरा असर मुझ पर हुआ। तो फर्स्ट थिंग आई थॉट इज कि यार, मेरे लाइफ में इतनी छोटी छोटी चीज़ों को लेकर हम ग्रज रखते हैं, हम वो चीज़ अपने दिल में इतना, मतलब पॉइजन अपने दिल में ही डाल के उसमें हम उसी में यू नो वी हर्ट आवरसेल्व्स इन आवर लाइव्स। और यहाँ हम देख रहे हैं कि इतनी बड़ी चीज़ें हुई हैं इनके लाइफ में, एंड दे आर एबल टू ओवरकम दैट। यू नो, इट मेड मी थिंक अबाउट माई सेल्फ एंड ऑल माई रिलेशनशिप्स इन माई लाइफ विच आई हैव बीन सो हार्ड ऑन। सो आई फाउंड इट वेरी इंट्रोस्पेक्टिव दिस फिल्म। तो मैंने सॉ द फिल्म, आई सेड यार ये मुझे पूरे इंडिया में दिखाना है। तो आई सेड वी मस्ट गो डायरेक्ट टू टीवी, वी मस्ट गो डायरेक्ट टू टीवी, एंड इट्स बीन डब्ड इन 7 languages। सो इन तमिल इट विल प्ले एंटायरली, इन तमिल, इन तेलुगु। सो स्टार नेटवर्क का पूरा बुके हमारे साथ है, इट्स नॉट ओनली स्टार प्लस। तो स्टार प्लस विल शो द हिंदी वर्जन, वॉट यू सॉ इज द ओरिजिनल लैंग्वेज। कहीं पे अंग्रेजी है, कहीं पे हिंदी है, कहीं पे मलयालम है, और अंग्रेजी में सब टाइटल्स हैं। सो यू सॉ द ओरिजिनल वर्जन विच विल प्ले ऑन स्टार वर्ल्ड। स्टार प्लस विल प्ले द हिंदी वर्जन, तमिल, तेलुगु, बंगाली, मराठी, ऑल द वेरियस डब्स विल प्ले द वेरियस वर्जन, बिकॉज वी वॉन्ट इट टू बी सीन अक्रॉस द कंट्री इन अ वेरी वाइड वे, यू नो, टू हैव अ डीप इम्पैक्ट ऑन ऑल ऑफ अस।
आमिर सर, अनोखिया गुजरात मित्र से आपके सामने यहाँ बहुत ही बेहतरीन बनी है, और हम सब देख रहे थे, हमारी आंखों से आंसू आ रहे थे। और स्वाति जी, बहुत अच्छा संदेश दिया है कि क्षमा करने में वीरता है, आक्रमण करने में कोई वीरता नहीं है। तो बहुत स्ट्रांग मैसेज है। मारिया जी के फैमिली, सिस्टर मारिया जी के फैमिली और अवंतिका जी के फैमिली को आपने कैसे कन्विंस किया? क्योंकि ये ऐसा दर्द है कि लोग जल्दी बांटना नहीं चाहते, जो दबा हुआ दर्द है वो कहीं ना कहीं बाहर आ जाता है। तो किस तरह से आपने उनकी फैमिली को कन्विंस किया?
एक्चुअली एक रिश्ता बनाना ज़रूरी होता है, और मैंने उन्हें जब अप्रोच किया तो सिर्फ एक फिल्म मेकर के हैसियत से, या मुझे ये मेरा प्रोजेक्ट है, मैंने उस तरह से उनको उनसे मिली नहीं, बल्कि जेन्युइनली मैं उन्हें मिलना चाह रही थी फ्रॉम एज वन ह्यूमन बीइंग टू अनदर। और फिर इस तरह से कुछ रिश्ता बनता गया कि चीज़ें होती रही। सो रियली उन्हें कन्विंस करना इस तरह से कोई, देयर वाज नो नीड फॉर इट एट ऑल, इट डिडंट, दैट काइंड ऑफ सिचुएशन डिडंट अराइज। इट काइंड ऑफ बिल्ड इनटू अ रिलेशनशिप एंड देन थिंग्स स्टार्टेड फ्लोइंग फ्रॉम इट, ऑलमोस्ट वन थिंग आफ्टर अनदर। एक्चुअली हमने स्क्रिप्ट बिल्कुल नहीं की थी, और इन 3 कहानियों को जोड़ने में और उनको चिजल आउट करने में आई थिंक सबसे ज़्यादा श्रेय मेरे एडिटर हेमंती सरकार को जाता है, क्योंकि उन्होंने इस चीज़ को, शी जस्ट टुक अ बिग ब्लॉक ऑफ स्टोन एंड शी हैज़ कार्व्ड समथिंग आउट ऑफ इट। तो मेरे रशेस थे, और हमने जानबूझकर ये, मेरा ये मानना था कि मुझे अनस्क्रिप्टेड करना है पूरा, और वॉट एवर लाइफ थ्रोज अप एंड वॉट एवर द कैरेक्टर्स गाइड यू इन अ पर्टिकुलर डायरेक्शन, फॉलो दैट डायरेक्शन इंस्टेड ऑफ ट्राइंग टू मेक द characters or the story follow a direction that you already have in mind. तो ultimately उससे 3 कहानियाँ कैसे, किस तरह से बनाना, a lot of it was actually in Hemanti's hands.
Hi Amit, on your right. Hi Faridun. Brilliant film. It was very very engrossing. And as you rightly said that.
By the way, this is not a press conference, not a Q&A. मतलब it's a Q&A. not a press conference.
Right.
So just feel free and ask whatever you want. We just want to know what you feel in your heart.
Right. So it doesn't, you rightly said it doesn't feel like a documentary because it's extremely engaging. So my question to you is that the best part is it's very objective. There are certain elements, be it the entire 1984 element and the 2611. So it's both the sides have been taken in a very objective manner. We are living in a time when there's a lot of noise all around us. So how important was it for you to just convince yourself that, because anything that you say or do, which is other than entertainment, you're judged very minutely, to maybe make a statement when you're making a statement as far as the 84 and 2611 is concerned, especially?
Well, I think that what the film is saying is much larger than any one event. It's talking about forgiveness, and it's talking about the power of, the healing power of forgiveness. And I remember my mom used to always tell me when I was a kid. Ammi hamesha kehti thi ki maafi mein jo taqat hai wo aur kisi cheez mein nahi. The biggest thing you can do is to forgive someone who has hurt you or upset you. So my mom used to always tell me that. And I really believe that. And like Kia Sher was saying, that often forgiveness is not about letting off somebody off the hook. It is letting yourself free. If you have done a crime, you will be punished for the crime as per the law of the land. But usse main, if I have lost something in that, aapko punishment milne se mera dard to abhi bhi nahi jayega. You follow? So she, it's like, she said, you know, it's like taking poison and hoping your enemy will die. So the healing power of forgiveness starts with yourself. And that is what I think the thought of the film is. And some of them are, I mean, events are connected to political events, okay. But the comment is not about these political events, actually. It's about the feeling of the person who was going through it.
Amir, Atika Faruqi from Colors. सवाल नहीं है ये मेरे ख्याल से एक दो महीने में जो सबसे अच्छी चीज़ हमने देखी है आज वो ये है और बहुत अच्छा लगा डॉक्यूमेंट्री का बिल्कुल हम इसे नाम नहीं देंगे मुझे याद आ रही है एक बहुत अच्छी हॉलीवुड फिल्म थी शॉन पेन के ऊपर वो उसके लीड एक्टर थे एक नन थी जो उनको जो प्रोसेस था प्रिजन में उसे सेल थ्रू करवाती हैं और मैंने पहली बार ये फॉरगिवनेस का जो प्रोसेस होता है वो वहाँ देखा था और मैंने सोचा था कि हमारे ऐसी फिल्में क्यों नहीं बनती और कितना अच्छा होगा अगर ये फिल्म हम बिल्कुल उसी तरह रिलीज़ करें जैसे एक फिल्म रिलीज़ की जाती है काश हमारे देश में भी एक वो टाइम आए जहाँ ये एक ऐसा मुद्दा जो है वो एक कमर्शियल टॉपिक हो और लोग जाके इसको देखें आपने खालिस्तान को उठाया टेररिज्म को उठाया और जो कन्वर्जन को लेके जो एक पॉलिटिकल माहौल बनाया जाता है उसको उठाया बहुत अच्छी तरह से पॉलिटिकल मुद्दे किस तरह से एक आम आदमी को असर करते हैं जो क्रीम है या जो बहुत इन्फ्लुएंशियल लोग हैं वो तो हट जाते हैं लेकिन एक आम आदमी किस तरह से उसमें साइकोलॉजिकली इमोशनली स्पिरिचुअली डैमेज हो जाता है वो दिखाया एंड वी मेक कंटेंट हम शोज बनाते हैं आई हैव बीन डूइंग दिस फॉर 15 इयर्स नाउ आई थिंक आई एम टेकिंग समथिंग फ्रॉम दिस फिल्म एंड आई विल मेक इट अ पॉइंट कि मेरे कंटेंट में कहीं ऐसी बात हो जो किसी की लाइफ बदले थैंक यू
सो मच
I think I have a question each for both of you. I think we, somewhere I think I'd like resonate what she feels. I think it's a very powerful sort of feeling to watch the film. My question first for you, Amir, is like she rightly said, there have been so many topics that you sort of touched here. I mean, you know, the entire team did, which might be considered sensitive in our current climate. Our current climate has been going on for too many years now. You've also been a part of them when you've tried to make strong statements through your films. You've been amid controversies yet. When you were listening to the story and you wanted a release like this that could reach everybody, was that fear still there that there will be certain sects who would still find it unfair to them or would feel that, you know, in some way there is they're being unfair to us? Was that feeling there ever?
You know, I think no matter what you do in life, there will be people who think differently. So if you start wondering that people are going to think differently, then you'll have to stop doing anything. Whatever you do, somebody will find a problem with it, no matter what you do. So I think the best thing that one can do is when you feel something with your heart in a very honest way, in a very sincere way, you should follow that, is what I believe.
It was more about like Avantika ji and me, or Samundar bhaiya and me, or you know, Sister Selmi and me. And as the film went on, many of my own preconceived notions were crumbling. And I also had to deal with things. So it is not just that they had to deal with it, I had to also realize and deal with and understand ki bhai, somehow everyone, when they start looking into their hearts and speaking, show you their humanity. And that is the most valuable thing that happens. So when that happens, somewhere there's that human to human connection, then that resistance and convincing and all become absolutely like unnecessary.
Hi.
Okay.
What made you take these three stories? What research and why these three stories?
Well, Sana, I had quite a few stories, and ultimately there is a certain restriction of time. So we had to pick three. I think for me, these three stories, the other stories were also very good and could have worked. But for me, they represented three decades of our country. So that was nice. So I kind of got a time span, which I felt was important. And there were different, because of the time span, I think that what the people in the stories, for want of a better word, I'm calling them characters, they went through their journeys over different periods of time. So you tend to process things differently when it's happened 30 years back, 20 years back, 10 years back, 5 years back. So for me, that whole span of time really helped a lot. So yeah, and one of the things is that Mumbai is my city. So I very much wanted that story personally to be there. So really, yeah, these were the reasons why. I think that I wouldn't want to pick between those two specific words, but I feel that any process that is constructive versus a process that is destructive adds to the overall goodness and positivity in the universe. So I think as a human being, I would like to pick something that's constructive as opposed to something that's destructive.
Akanksha here from Cineblitz. Two questions I have. First of all, how did you, human psychology, we would always want to kind of sympathize with the victim and the survivor over, you know, the someone who has perpetrated that crime. So how difficult or how much of a challenge was it for you to have, like, I felt that paradigm shift in me where for once I felt maybe it is okay to forgive, maybe that person acted in, had his own reasons to do whatever. But as a filmmaker, how challenging was it for you to have that balance brought in where you're not justifying the crime yet supporting in a way that it is okay to forgive?
Actually, honestly, it would have been very difficult if I had to artificially try and create a balance. And you know, see, my very first job in life was as a journalist. We were always told objectivity. But I always felt that actually in truth, there is no objectivity. Because no matter how much you strive, you as a human being have a perspective. So your subjectivity creeps in no matter what. What happened in this case was that I didn't really start by saying balance or anything. I said, I will open myself up to whoever is sitting there. And I'm a person who's deeply always interested in other people's stories. I always want to hear and know more like about people. I'm deeply interested in human stories. So when, you know, let's say a Cookie Ji or a Samundar Bhaiya, when they started talking, ek rishta banta gaya, honestly. I'm in touch with everyone, you know. And as I said, they just showed me their humanity. And I have to confess that when I started on this film, the journey of the film, since you're asking this question, in my personal life, I was going through something hugely traumatic, something that had happened to one of my children. And I had actually been wanting to wreak revenge on someone. Because if you get hurt, then you take it. If your child does something, then you, like, as a mother, you know. Right. And then I started realizing how much poison and hatred there was inside me. And when I started talking to all these people, that process healed me as well. So, dheere dheere, a balance came into my own being also. So maybe that is the balance that has come out in the film.
This is also a very, very positive something I think that the world needs to see, not just India. I think everyone needs to imbibe and learn something from whatever you have shown. Do you plan to have a it in a part of series? Like, you know, like here you showed three stories. Would you want to continue showing some other aspects as well? Like, make it like a series?
See, as for me, I have not made any plans and I like to kind of be guided by whatever comes my way. So in a way, I'm waiting for things to happen. But let's see. One never knows.
You know, I have a request. A number of you are shooting this. Please don't put it on any platform. We don't. Penetration is very low. Penetration. Hoega, dheere dheere badega. Abhi bahut kam hai. So I wanted Indians to watch it. And I said, world ko bhi dikhayenge. Wo teen mahine ke baad dikhayenge. So that's why I chose to go Star and Hotstar.
I just wanted to compliment both Amir and Swati, both of you.
Khan Saab, Swati ji.
State, please.
Thank you, guys.
Amir, sir, up next. Please, sir.
चलो 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 चलो